Hi everyone, and welcome to another tutorial here on Vectortwist. Today I would like to show you how you can create simple animations with Illustrator and Photoshop. As you can see here on the artboard, I have an isometric illustration of a windmill. And I would like to show you how you can create a little animation where the windmill sails are turning. The illustration here is done in Illustrator, and we're going to set up our parts and then move over to Photoshop to create an animated GIF. So the first part that we need here is our windmill sails, and I've created this little shape here that's going to act as the sail. Right now you just see the flat version, and we're going to turn it into an isometric view. Now the simplest way to turn the sails into the isometric view here in Illustrator is to select it and apply an effect called 3D extrude and bevel. I have already done this, so I'm going to open up the appearance panel and turn on the 3D extrude and bevel. I'm going to double click it to show you the settings. I chose isometric right, the extrude depth is 10, and it's a diffuse shading. Now if I move the cells over to the windmill, you can see that they fall right into place with the rest of the illustration. Now in order to animate this, we need two parts of the windmill. So we're going to create a copy, and then we're going to rotate our shape by 45 degrees. So let me turn off the 3D extrude and bevel. Then we're going to double click on the rotate tool, and in the pop-up we're going to check preview, and then set the angle to 45 degrees. Now as you can see, I simply rotated it 45 degrees, and then I press OK. I'll turn back on my 3D extrude and bevel, and if I move it directly over our first shape, you can see that we've created the illusion of a full wheel. Now when we go over to Photoshop to animate this, you'll see how we're going to create the illusion that it's going to rotate. Now we need four parts to animate this in Photoshop. We have our main illustration here, then two parts of our sails for the windmill, and a little extra that we're going to put on top, acting as a bolt. Now let's switch over to Photoshop. Now here in Photoshop, just open up a regular document. Then go to Window, Workspace, and then choose Motion. This will open up the timeline here on the bottom, and you'll see your layers. Once you switch the workspace, we're going to create four layers. We have four parts that we need to copy over from Illustrator, and then we're going to set up our animation here in Photoshop. So let's go back to Illustrator and select our assets. On our first layer, we want to have our isometric windmill illustration. So let's select it, let's create a copy, and then switch back to Photoshop. Here we're simply going to paste what we've just copied from Photoshop. I usually paste it as a smart object, just in case. So let's press OK, and then press Enter. Right away we want to call our layer windmill, so we're not getting confused. Then again, switching back to Illustrator. This time we're going to select the first part of our sails for our windmill. We create a copy, and then switch back to Photoshop. Paste it. Again, smart object, press OK. Do not change the size. Going to put it into place, press Enter. Right away we're going to call our layer something logical, like sail number one. Then again, back to Illustrator, we'll grab the second part of our sail, create a copy, switch back to Photoshop, paste it in, and move it into the exact same position. Now we're calling it sail number two. And as you can see, we have three layers right now. Now we need one more part from Illustrator, our little red bolt. We'll create a copy, switch back to Photoshop, paste it in, and put it into position. Now we are ready to create our animation. Now here on the bottom, you can see the timeline. And then it says create frame animation. So let's select this. We'll have a first frame where every layer is visible. But at this particular moment, we don't need to have both sails visible. So on the first frame here in our timeline, we're going to turn off sail number two. Then we're going to click the icon for another frame. Here we're going to turn on sail number two, but we're going to turn off sail number one. Then we're going to create another frame. We turn off sail number two, and we'll turn on sail number one. And then one more frame, and we repeat this, turn off sail number one, turn on sail number two. Now if I click on my frame number one and press the play button, you can see now how we created a simple animation. It's going a little bit fast, so I'm just going to choose frame number two and three. You can do this by pressing the shift key and then clicking on the frames, and then change it to 0.1 seconds, and then it just creates a little bit of a slowdown of the animation. Now when we go to File, Export, Save for Web, we're going to choose a GIF, and then we can check it again here if we press play. It'll slow it down a little bit, but the actual animation will be a tad faster. And then we can just save it to any location we desire. And here you can see the animated GIF we've created with Illustrator and Photoshop. It's really easy to create simple animations here. You have your assets in Illustrator, you copy them over into Photoshop, and use the timeline to create frame-by-frame animations. I hope you really enjoyed this small tutorial here. Please subscribe to the channel and also check out Vectortwist.com for more tutorials on how to use Illustrator. I'll see you next time.